On last month's updates, we have a newly rebranded documentation site. It features a new information structure that is more aligned with the process of app building rather than being strictly tied to how things are organized in FlutterFlow's UI. This may seem a bit overwhelming at first for long-time users, but let me walk you through it. First, we now have a roadmap to guide you through the different layers of app building. For example, the UI layer focuses on widgets and components, which essentially make up the user interface. Next, we guide you through the logic layer, which primarily references our state management documentation and how to work with actions and business logic. Finally, we cover the data layer, which includes references to authentication, databases, and API integrations. On the sidebar, this information is divided into six major categories. Understanding the FlutterFlow UI. This section helps you navigate the platform and familiarize yourself with where everything is located. Resources. Here, you will find the fundamentals of app building in FlutterFlow. This includes understanding data, how it's stored in FlutterFlow, basic UI elements, managing conditional logic, and more. Building concepts. These are the core app building concepts that you might use when creating an app. In fact, these concepts are not exclusive to FlutterFlow. They can be applied to any app building journey. And the new documentation also includes more explanations of the why before diving into the how-tos. Testing and publishing. Once you've built your app, this section provides tips and tricks for deploying it. Integrations. This category covers various integrations like payments and maps. Generated code. This new section, still a work in progress, goes deeper into the generated code base and the architecture behind the key features in the UI. Currently, you can find information on the directory structure, the FFAppState class, the PageModel class, and more. In fact, in some topics, we also include extra notes explaining what happens behind the scenes in the generated code when you enable certain features, which are very useful for developers who are curious about what happens when they toggle something in the UI. In fact, for how-tos, we now offer more interactive assets that guide you through features which strategically place hotspots and instructions, avoiding long blocks of text. Additionally, most of the new documentation uses the same e-commerce demo app to illustrate examples, so you can always refer to the final project to see how things were done. And one great aspect of this new documentation is that it is open source, so anyone can contribute. If you feel something is not explained correctly or notice a typo, you can fix it yourself. Or you can create an issue in the repository if something is missing and needs the FlutterFlow team's attention. That's all for the new docs. We are excited to hear what you think about it. Additionally, there were some small updates that landed in the product last month. We have a brand new UI for the Action Flow Editor. In the new UI, this is how you can choose action triggers for widgets that don't have any actions yet. And if you want to add any additional action triggers, you can add them from the left panel. Stay tuned for more updates in this space next month. Previously, constants didn't work in real-time previews, but now you can preview them directly on the canvas as you build a UI that utilizes constants. Additionally, we have added more utility functions around data types and enums. For example, you can now easily rename them or search for the desired one if you have a long list. And I have kept the best news for the last. Last month, we introduced FlutterFlow Developer Groups, or FFDGs, around the world, where local groups are hosting meetups and events around FlutterFlow. Currently, we have meetup groups in Poland, US, India, Tokyo, Philippines, and other 15 plus countries. You can visit meetup.com to find out if there's a local chapter near you and join the next event or session. If you are interested in creating a group in your city, you can scan this QR code to apply. And that's all for August, as we are working on bringing some amazing features for FFDC happening on the 17th and 18th of September. Join us in New York or virtually and let us know in the comments which features you're most excited to see released at FFDC.